Sadness you gave me, You put the hate on me, you sucked it to the mama. When you say goodbye, so please walk on by. Oh mama, make believe you never see the tears of cry. So I'm begging you to walk on by. Oh yeah. Make believe you never see the tears of cry. So I'm begging you to walk on by. Make believe you never see the tears of cry. Oh, there's no dust in my eye. Oh no. Smoke ain't making me cry. No, no, no. We'll be right back.
Thank you. If you see me walking down the street and I start to cry, it's time we meet. Walk on by. Make believe that you don't see the tears. Oh, just let me grieve. In private, because each time I see you, I break down and cry. Walk on by.
I just can't
get over losing you. So if I seem broke in two, please walk on by. Foolish pride is all that I have left. So let me hide the tears and sadness you gave me. I didn't ask for it. When you said goodbye, make believe you never see the tears again. So I do me a favor and walk on by. Please, walk on by. I just can't get over losing you. So if I seem broken too, walk on by. Walk on by. Foolish pride, all that I have left. So let me hide the tears and the sadness. When you said goodbye, so please walk on by. Oh, make believe you never see the tears I cry. So do me a favor and walk on by. So I'm begging you to walk on by. Oh, yeah. Make believe you never see the tears I cry. So I'm begging you. I'm begging you to walk on by. Make believe you never see the tears I cry. Oh, there's no dust in my eye. Oh no. Smoke ain't making me cry.
If you see me walking down the street and I start to cry each time we meet, walk on by. Walk on by. Make believe that you don't see the tears. Just let me grieve in private, 'cause each time I see you, I break down and cry. Walk on by.
Stop.
Stop. Walk on by.
Stop. Stop.
Walk on by.
Stop. Thank you. Yeah, that was such a oh, Lilo. It is not often that we see isiPantsula broken down in this kind of a way where it is slowed down for us to see the intricate movements of what it is, the elements of what isiPantsula is. And for us, you know, at the Center for the Less Good Ideas, it's such a privilege to have the experience of Impilo Mapantsula and Jeremy Nedd and that long collaboration that they've had. That has enabled us to witness, you know, isiPantsula in this kind of a way, you know, being made right in front of us, seeing people learning choreographies. They challenge each other all the time, you know, to do something, you know, like this. And it has been such a privilege. Earlier on, we had like 55 students from, you know, Vets University who also experienced them in rehearsal at 2 o'clock. So this is the second, you know, showing of the day. Open rehearsal. And if you've got any questions, Matthew, can we have lights on the audience as well? If there's any question, and it's okay to not have a question, don't worry, it's not like, you know, it's fine. If you feel you're satisfied, you've seen what you wanted to, you know, to see. If you have a comment as well, you know, there's a mic there because this is work in progress, and they will also like to hear how people receive it, you know, the beginnings of what they are doing. So, you have anything to say, Jeremy? Anybody? Nothing? Audience? 2 audience members there. There should be a mic there. I won't be answering questions.
It's working.
I'll start with Jeremy there because it's the direct.
Yes, I think I was really interested in music choice. How did you get here with Walk On By, which I think, I don't know, I'm young, I know that song, and it's been, you know, it's a nice, it's a great song, and I'm trying to figure out, isiPantsula with this, how did you go here?
How did I get there? Well, I guess the way I got there was mostly through this idea of revisiting, reimagining, speculating, fabulating what a Western could have been. And at first in the research, I was watching a lot of these traditional Westerns, like The Good, The Bad, The Ugly. And then I just got bored of it. And then I started focusing more on the 70s, blaxploitation, black cinema era. And for me, what I really liked about these films is it kind of created a certain anachronism, where they would place the thing in the old West, but then they would have, like, you know, Sly and the Family Stone, like, you know, meow, meow, meow. So it kind of created this cinematic feel, but it was something that was, I guess, from, you know, my perspective, like, I don't know, just a black embodiment of, like, a cinematic vision or like an image that you can kind of put on top of that. So when it came to bringing this to them, I was like, okay, there's this mean drum loop at the end. And for me, that was the whole thing. I was like, how do I get to this drum loop? And it was just a happy marriage. And then they kind of introduced me to Swanka, which is kind of like this performance of, you know, self. And for me, these things just kind of really fit together somehow. And was still at least true to Pantsula when we get to like the drum loop. So that was kind of how I arrived there. And with the use of the second version of Walk On By, that was just kind of like, I guess I think it's cool to hear things from many sides to kind of, you know, to get like another absence besides like, you know, black bodies in the Western cinematic history. It's kind of also like a female lead presence, so to say. So this was something I thought that can kind of be triggered through using the female version as well. And of course, the beautiful female dancers. So that's kind of how I arrived there. Hope it answers the question. Okay. And sorry we went a bit over. Apologies, but I hope y'all had fun.
That's cool. Hi, everyone, first and foremost. So I kind of saw the story when it was starting out, right? They showed us Umchi Delapaya with the yellow beanie. He was showing us, I don't know, was that a sense of looking at materialistic elements? As in, like, we focused too much on the brand, so much so that the watch, we didn't even know where to adequately put it. Or was that, I don't know, with the watch thing being on his foot, what was that? Was that house arrest? Was that saying that we're using those tools inadequately, inefficiently? What was that about?
Actually, the watch was a bit of a surprise. We've been working, there's been a lot of surprises. So it's rehearsal. So this watch was a surprise, that I appreciate the surprise. But the actual use of Oswanka, this is more, a tool to perform a certain template that would, you know, construct masculinity or construct the idea of femininity, and which is kind of like a part of these tropes that really fueled what this Western cinematic thing was. So I thought it was really interesting to find a form that was really based in something South African to be the vehicle for that. For us, we actually won't be using so much watches and actual jewelry, but it is kind of just this performance of, okay, an idea of masculinity. And also it's kind of a character construction technique. It's like, you don't know the names, you don't know who's who. We're not actually telling any story, but just by seeing, okay, this guy comes out, he's like, hey, yo, what's up, hey. And we have a very classic look. We have kind of a bit more, we have a giant. It's just like, kind of, how do you create new leading roles for mythical characters, so to say, or like legendary characters through this form. So that's more that what it was. And the watch was and the green sock was a surprise. Tom likes to bring the surprises. So that's what that was.
It looks like there are no more questions, which is okay. Oh, William, you have a question.
It's both a question, but it's also just a comment. It's just astonishing to see Pantsula done in this way. And each time it went on, I thought it's not possible that people are still breathing, that they can still move. And I wondered how much of that is very clearly set in what you're doing and how much is really being tested in the moment as you're going on. Presumably the moves, those complicated moves, can't be learned by just watching it once. Because that for me was astonishing the way it grew, but I also didn't believe that it could have been completely set at each moment.
Evening, everyone. Firstly, thank you for attending this occasion. And also thanks, William, because this is the center for the Les Good Idea, and isiPantsula, as we know the history of South Africa, we tend to ignore what belongs in our backyard. So we are a product of a rejection when you look at the history. I can say we are of a Les Good Idea, hence why we are welcomed at the center for the Les Good Idea. Since this is still a process, I can say 70% of the stuff, it has been pre-rehearsed, even though it's not clean. And we haven't yet got 100% of the movements. And then 30%, it was also a feeling and also surprise elements. As much as Pala had said before that we always have surprises for each other and always pushing each other, you know, and challenging each other. Thanks.
And I think with that less good idea note, you know, let's call it a night. You know, before we spoil the broth. You know, so I think thank you guys for agreeing to open yourself to this, you know, moment of rehearsal and sharing work in progress than finished work. But that's what the center exists for, and I'm very grateful that you agreed to this and for being here and embracing us in all our craziness. And it was such a beautiful thing. William wants to say something?
Just to say, I think all of us are appreciative just how remarkable it is to see a work at this stage also. There are things that we've been able to see tonight that we know no one else will see when it's polished and shiny and with a huge audience, to be this intimate and see the thinking going, the challenging, the kind of the exhaustion to which you put yourself in doing it feels an extraordinary privilege. So I'm sure on behalf of the whole audience, thank you for opening it for us.
Good night and travel safely. Thank you.